Good morning. Myself Priya, working as an assistant professor, Department of Mechatronics Engineering, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. I am handling the subject Transducer Engineering, course code is 18PCMT 4.6. Today, let us discuss about the topic Science of Measurements and Classification of Transducer. First, need for measurement in physics. To understand any phenomena in physics, we have to perform experiments. Okay? Experiments require measurements. And we have measured several physical properties like length, mass, time, temperature, pressure, etc. Experimental verification of laws and theories also needs measurement of physical properties. A physical property that can be measured and described by a number is called physical quantity. For example, mass of a person is 65 kg. So, the mass is represented by the kg. Length of the table is 3 meter. Okay. So, length is represented by the meter. Area of the hall is 100 meter square. Okay. So, the unit of the area is meter square. Next, temperature. It's represented by Kelvin. Okay. Next, what are the types of physical quantities? Fundamental quantities, the physical quantities which do not depend on any other physical quantities for their measurements are known as fundamental quantities. For example, mass, time, length, temperature. These are the fundamental quantities. In day-to-day life, we are using these terms. Okay. Next one is the derived quantities. The physical quantities which depend on one or more fundamental quantities for their measurements are known as derived quantities. For example, area, speed, volume, force. This is the derived quantities depending on the some parameters. Okay. Next, unit for measurement. The standard used for the measurement of a physical quantity is called a unit. For example, meter, foot, inch for length, kilogram, pound for mass, second, minute, hour for time, Kelvin for temperature. What are the characteristics of unit? It's a well-defined one, suitable size. It's a reproducible, invariable, indisturbable, internationally acceptable. Okay. In units also, first internationally acceptable, and then we have to use to day-to-day life. Okay. Next, international system of unit, that means SI units. In 1971, General Conference on Weight and Measures held its meeting and decided a system of unit for international usage. This system is called International System of Units and abbreviated as SI from its French name. The SI unit consists of 7 fundamental units and 2 supplementary units. Thus, what are the 7 fundamental units? Okay. In fundamental quantity, length, SI unit means meter. What is the symbol of this one? Meter. Okay, M. What is the fundamental quantity for it's a mass. Next one is the SI unit is kilogram and the symbol is kg. Next one is the time. It's an SI unit second and symbol is S. What is the temperature SI unit? It's a Kelvin K. Electric current means ampere and the symbol is A. Luminance intensity means scintilla. So symbol is CD. Amount of substance means moles. So we have to put the symbol is mole. What is the definition of meter? The meter is length of the path traveled by light in a vacuum to reach a time travel of 1 divided by 29 lakhs of second. Okay. Definition of kilogram. The kilogram is the mass of prototype cylinder of platinum radium alloy preserved at the International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Sivios in near Paris. Okay. What is the definition of second? 1 second is the time taken by the lakhs of time oscillations of the light emitted by the cesium-133 atom. Next one is the what is meant by standards? A standard is a repeatable, harmonized, agreed and documented way of doing something. Standards contain technical specifications or other precise criteria designed to be used consistently as a rule, guide, guideline or definition. They help to make life simpler and increase the reliability and the effectiveness of many of the goods and services we use. Okay. Standards of machine, the international prototype meter and the international yard are considered to be perfect or master standards. This cannot be used for general purpose. For practical and shop floor measurements, there is need for of working standards. For example, micrometer, vernier rules, etc. are required for measurement in workshop. These are calibrated from the slip gauge and slip gauges would be calibrated against the laser by the National Physical Laboratory. This depending upon the degree of accuracy required for the work. The standards are the subdivided into following four categories grades. One is the primary standards, that means the reference standard. Next one is the secondary standards, which represent as the calibration standards. Third one is the territory standards, that means inspection standards. Fourth one is the working standard, that means workshop measuring standards. First, we have to discuss the primary standard, that means it's a master standard. Primary standard is also known as the master standard and preserved under the most careful condition. These standards are not commonly in use. They are used only after long intervals. They are slowly used for comparing the secondary standards. Sometimes it is also called reference standard. Okay, this is the primary standard. Next one is the secondary standard. It's also known as a calibration standards. The secondary standard is more or less similar to the primary standard. They are nearly close in accuracy with the primary standard. The secondary standard is compared to regular interval with primary standard and record their deviations. These standards are distributed to a number of places where they are kept under safe custody. They are used occasionally for comparing the territory standards. The standards are used in the laboratory also. Third one is the territory standard, that means inspection standards. The territory standard is the first standard to be used for reference purpose in workshops and laboratories. They are used for comparing the working standards. They are not used as frequently and commonly as the working standard, but more frequency than secondary standards. Territory standards should also be maintained as a reference for comparison in intervals and working standards. Fourth one is the working standards. That means it's in workshop measuring standards. The working standards is used for actual measurement in workshops or laboratories by the workers. These standards should also be as accurate as possible to the territory standard. But sometimes lower grades of material can be used for the manufacturing to reduce cost. Next one is the calibration. Calibration is nothing but activity of checking. By comparing with a standard, the accuracy of a measuring instrument of any type. It may also include adjustment of the instrument to bring it into an alignment with the standard. Why calibration is necessary? It is impossible to make perfect hardware that would not need any form of error correction. Even making the hardware would enough to eliminate the need for error correction for most device would be extremely expensive. The best balance is to make the hardware as good as practically possible, balancing performance and cost. Calibration is then a very useful tool to improve measurement accuracy. What is the importance of calibration? Calibration of your measuring equipment or working standard enables the user to take note of the deviations and errors from the nominal values so that the corrections can be made to minimize the error during measurements. A well-calibrated instrument provides the confidence to the user as well as the consumer that the service or the product meets the required specifications. and ensure the acceptance in international water. Okay. What is the purpose of the calibration? Calibration refers to the act of evaluating and adjusting the principal precision and accuracy of measurement equipment. Instrument calibration is intended to eliminate or reduce bias in an instrument reading over a range for all continuous value. In precision is the degree to which repeated measurement under unchanged condition show the same result. Okay, same result. What is meant by accuracy? It is a degree of closeness of measurement of a parameter to its actual true value. Okay, in a laboratory, we are doing the some experiments. Means first we are doing the precision and accuracy. Okay, finally we get this answer in this depending upon this parameter. Next one is the static calibration. Static calibration, a procedure in which the value of the variable involved remain constant. The static calibration do not change with the time. Okay, this is the important thing. Dynamic calibration means change with time. Okay, when the variable of interest, the time dependent and time based information is needed. The dynamic calibration determines the relationship between the input of known dynamic behavior and the measurement system output. Next one is the static curve. Static calibration curve. What is mean by sensitivity? It is defined as the ratio of the change in the magnitude of the output to the change in the magnitude of measurement. That is, the sensitivity is the output by the input approximation. Del it's a represent the change. Okay, change in output by change in input. In other words, the slope of a calibration curve. This is the slope. Okay, it provides the sensitivity of the measurement system. Okay, this one is the static sensitivity. The slope of a static calibration curve, it relates changes in the indicator output to change in the output to the change in the input. Okay, this is the calibration curve. Same x-axis. Okay, it's an input value. Y-axis the output value. Okay, this dotted line indicating the measured value. Okay, the straight line curve fit y is equal to f of x. Okay, then k x1 is equal to dy by dx, change with output by change in input. When means x is equal to x1. Okay, the x value is equal to the x1 value means we have to find up this number. Okay, this is the y is equal to f of x. Okay, this is the, this graph is represented by the static calibration curve. Okay, next one is the dynamic calibration. What is mean by dynamic calibration? It's a change with time. Okay, we have seen so far how to obtain the input-output relationship of an instrument when the input is held constant, neglecting the measurement system dynamics. This process is called static calibration. However, when the input variables of interest are time dependent and time-based information is sought, we know to consider the system dynamics. A dynamic calibration determines the relationship between an input of known dynamic behavior and the measurement system output. Usually, such calibration involves either a sinusoidal signal or a step changes as the known input signal. Okay, the to perform a static calibration, we use a piecewise constant functions as input. The measurement can only be performed when the system reaches steady state conditions. Okay, errors in measurements. What is meant by error? Error is nothing but difference between the actual value of the quantity and the value obtained by a measurement is called an error. In simple form, error is nothing but difference between the true value minus approximate value. Okay, in simple way of looking at the error is the difference between true value. on the approximate value. Okay, here it's representing the E is equal to true value minus approximate value. If we are making physical measurement, there is always error involved. The error is noted by using the delta. That means the symbol followed by the variable represent the quantity measured. For example, if we are measuring volume, the error in measuring the volume would be symbol is del V. Okay, del is nothing but the change. What is the types of errors? Okay, first one is the cross error. Cross error is nothing but the it's happened by the human. Next one is the random error. Next, systematic error. Constant, absolute error, relative error, percentage error. First, we have discussed about the cross error. A cross error caused by a human mistakes in reading or using instruments. Okay, in regular lab also we are using some experiments. Okay, at the time we have the value is 8.5 mils. In human reading, some mistake is there. We reading the 8. Some variation in the readings. Okay, may also occur due to incorrect adjustment of the instrument and the computational mistakes. Okay, it cannot be treated mathematically. It's eliminate but can minimize. For example, improper use of instrument. Okay, this error can be minimized by taking proper care in readings and recording measurement parameter. In general, indicating instrument change ambient condition to some extent when connected into a complete circuit. Therefore, several readings must be taken to minimize the effect of ambient condition changes. Next one is the systematic error. Systematic error due to shortcoming of the instrument, such as defective or worn parts, aging, or effects of the environment on the instrument. In general, systematic error can be subdivided into static and dynamic error. Static, which means caused by a limitations of the measuring device or the physical laws governing its behavior. Dynamic means caused by the instrument not responding very fast enough to follow the changes in the measured variable. What are the types of systematic error? It's an instrumental error, environmental error, observational error. What is meant by instrumental error? Inherent while measuring instrument because of their mechanical structure. For example, direction meter, friction in the bearings of various moving components, irregular spring tension, stretching of spring. Okay, error can be avoided by what are the procedure to avoid the errors? Okay, three types is there. First one is the selecting a suitable instrument for the particular measurement application. Next, apply correction factor by determining instrumental error. Third one is the calibrate the instrument against standard. Okay. Next one is the environmental error. Environmental error, it's due to external condition affecting the measurement, including surrounding area condition, such as change in temperature, humidity, barometer, pressure. That's all. This is the day-to-day life we have to causes. Okay, in temperature, humidity, day to in every second it changes. Okay, these parameters. How to avoid this error? Use air conditioner. In temperature high means we are using the air conditioner, means temperature level will be reduced. Sealing second component in the instrument. Use magnetic sealed. Okay, this is the avoid temperature humidity. Next one is the observational error. It's introduced by the observer. Most common parallax error and estimation error while reading the scale. For example, an observer who tend to hold his hand too far the left while reading the position of the needle on the scale. Next one is the random error. Random error is nothing but causes by the unknown cases occur when all systematic error has accounted. Accumulation of small effect require a high degree of accuracy. How to avoid this error? it's increasing number of readings. Okay, once we are taking the one two readings means it's increase your readings 10 times or 20 times. Okay, next one is the use statistical means to obtain best approximation of true value. Next topic is transducer. Okay, what is mean by transducer? Transducer is a device. It converts energy, one form of energy, into the another form of energy. Alternatively, a transducer is defined as a device which provides useful output response to a specific input measured. Then maybe a physical quantity. A transducer can also be defined as a device when actuated by energy in one system supplies energy in the same form or in another form to a second system. What is the classification of transducer? Transducer may be classified according to their application, method of energy conversion, nature of the output signal, and so on. Okay. What is the main difference between transducer and sensors? Transducer is nothing but it converts the one form of energy to another form of energy. But sensor is sensing some physical quantities. Okay. What are the types of transducer? Okay. In transducer, it's classified into five types. One is the basis of principle used. Next one is the active and passive transducer. Third one is the primary and secondary transducer. Fourth one is the analog and digital transducer. Fifth, transducer and inverse transducer. Okay, on the basis of principles used, its further classification is there. Okay, three types. One is the capacitive, inductive and resistive transducer. First, let us discuss about the what is mean by active transducer. These transducers do not need any external source of power for their operation. Therefore, they are also called a self-generating type transducer. Okay, first, active transducer means it do not require any external source. Okay, it's used itself. The active transducer are self-generating device which operate under the energy conservation principle. Okay. Second one is the output of active transducer will get an equivalent electrical output signal. For example, temperature or strain to electric potential without any external source of energy being used. Next one is the passive transducer. What is mean by passive transducer? It's an opposite of active transducer. Okay, this transducer needs external source of power for their operation. So they are not self-generating type transducer because it wants some external sources. Okay, so DC power supply or an audio frequency generator is used as an external power source. This transducer produces the output signal in the form of variation in electrical parameter. Okay, like resistance, capacitance, and inductance type. Okay. For example, thermistor, potentiometer type transducer. It's a passive transducer. Okay. Thermistor means we have to calculate the temperature level. Next one is the primary and secondary transducer. Some transducers contain the mechanical as well as electrical device. The mechanical device converts the physical quantity to be measured into a mechanical signal. Such mechanical device are called as the primary transducer, because they deal with the physical quantity to be measured. The electrical device then converts the mechanical signal into a corresponding electrical signal. Okay, such electrical device are known as a secondary transducer. Next one is the analog transducer. This transducer convert the input quantity into an analog output, which is a continuous function of that. This is a strain gauge. And LVDT thermocouple or the transistor may be called as an analog transducer, as they give an output which is a continuous function of time. Okay. Next one is the digital transducer. This transducer converts the input quantity into an electrical output, which is the form of pulses, and its output is represented by zeros and ones. Okay. In digital form means we have to convert zeros or ones. Once we have to on means it's a one. Off means it's represented as a zero. Okay. Next, transducer and inverse transducer. transducer, it converts a non-electrical quantity into an electrical quantity. Next, some type of two types is there. One is the inverse transducer. Inverse transducer converts electrical quantity to a non-electrical quantity. It's a transverse of the trans. It's an opposite of the transducer. Okay, the piezoelectric crystal acts as an inverse transducer because when a voltage is applied across its surface, it changes its dimension, causing a mechanical displacement. Okay, what are the selection criteria of transducer? The following factors are to be considered while selecting a transducer for further applications. First one is the operating range. The range of transducer should be appropriate for measurement to get a good resolution. Okay, if the resolution is somewhat, it's not good, means we have to disconnect this operations. Okay, next, operating principle. The transducer are selected on the basis of operating principle. It may be resistive, inductive, capacitive, and optical. Okay, next one is the accuracy. The accuracy should be as high as possible or as per the measurement. Okay, next one is the accuracy. It's nothing but the closeness of the true value. Okay, range, it's nothing but the transducer can give good result within its specified range. So select transducer as per the operating range. Okay, next one is the sensitivity. Sensitivity is nothing but the difference between the changing output by changing input values. Okay, the transducer should be more sensitive to produce the output, or sensitivity should as per the requirement. Next one is the environmental compatibility. The transducer should maintain input and output characteristics for the selected environmental condition. Temperature sensor, it's an environment, it's depending on the environmental. Okay, if the temperature increases, means the values also increase in equipment. So it's an environmental compatibility is very important for the selection of transducer. Next one is the loading effect. The transducer's input impedance should be high and output impedance should be low to avoid loading effect. Okay, the high input impedance should be high and output impedance should be low, means we have to avoid the loading effect. Next one is the error. The error produced by the transducer should be low as possible. Okay, we have to calculate the errors value. We are using the lab equipments also, we are measuring more number of readings. Okay, more number of readings means we have to reduce the error also. So the what is the error? It's how to find out the error. It's a true value minus measurement value. Thank you.